Hello, everybody, and welcome to our new project, XCOM 2 Long War 2. Before we get started in the main game, I'd like to actually make a few announcements. First of all, I'd like to apologize for there being a lack of videos these last few days. The reason being is I tried to start a new project, which was Valiant Hearts, but unfortunately after uploading, I got copyright claims due to several songs that I didn't actually know were licensed songs. So unfortunately, I ended up having to scrap that recording and project and go back to the drawing board. Second of all, I'm actually going to be making a change in my recording schedule. Mondays through Thursdays, I'm going to be recording my main series, or putting up videos for my main series. But on Fridays, I'm going to be uploading a different game, you know, to break up the monotony of the same video day after day. I won't tell you what the game is yet. I'll leave that a surprise. Another thing is, like with my XCOM 2 game, or the original one, I am going to be playing with a lot of mods. All the mods that I'm using will be put into the description. And for those of you using Squad Conceal, you have to go into the INI and change the 0 to a 1. Otherwise, you're going to get this weird glitch with Long War 2 that causes your squad to go into concealment in the middle of a battle. One other thing. Anybody who's played Long War 2 knows that the very first introduction mission is kind of a difficult one, as in going with the Long War 2 motif of being challenging. And, well, because of the fact that I don't want a complete squad wipe on the very first mission, or have all of my soldiers out with wounds, because they're going to be the only skilled ones, there's going to be a lot of save scumming to prevent that from happening. So, to save you guys from having to watch that, I'm actually going to skip over the intro mission. Another thing is, I'm going to be playing with Red Fog on, but only for the aliens, because, you know, I'm a casual scrub. And I'll be playing on Rookie difficulty. Let's see, what else? There was something else I wanted to say, but I can't remember it. Oh, right. I'm actually going to be doing recordings differently because, well, as you know, missions work differently in Long War 2. Basically, if I'm at the very start of a mission and our time has run out for the episode, I'm going to basically just end the episode there and pick it off in the next episode at the beginning of that mission. But if I'm, say, right in the middle of the mission or right at the very end, I'm going to keep going and finish it off. There may even be the occasional episode where there's no mission at all. Just warning you about that right off the gate. Or right out of the gate. Also, if I didn't mention it, which I probably have, I'm going to be playing on Rookie difficulty because Long War 2 is challenging, and I'm a casual scrub. So, anyways, I'll see you guys at the end of the intro mission. Oh, but I will be showing the intro cinematic. You know, just for those of you who haven't seen it yet.
Excitement continues to build as city centers across the globe prepare for the 20th anniversary of Unification Day.
Thousands line up at the site of the Great Accord, celebrating the formation of the Advent Coalition.
Keeping with their promise to humanity, 12 new gene therapy clinics will be opening in select cities by the end of the new year.
Despite the attempted attack by fringe elements, operations at the new facility in Paris thankfully remain unaffected.
In response to the unprovoked intrusion on the eve of our most beloved celebration, the Speaker reaches out to us.
small number of dissidents again repeat the mistakes of the old world.
Striking as we celebrate the benevolent savior who time and again offers only friendship and compassion.
Yet these trivial actions could never break the bond between humanity and the elders.
Peacekeeping forces have already made several preemptive arrests of known collaborators. Advent again assures all citizens that today's celebrations will continue as planned.
Perfect.
The Advent administration reminds you to report all suspicious activity to your nearest peacekeeper.
Approaching position. You were right. They've definitely got their hands full today.
Stay focused. Prep gate crasher.
60 seconds.
Everybody, we're back after the mission. I managed to get a flawless, though primarily because I did some save scumming. And because I have the flawless mod installed, I actually got a bonus of 82 intel.
I've warned the crew to stay away from the Advent meat rations. We still don't know what they're putting in that stuff.
Now, I haven't promoted my soldiers yet, primarily because I have specific classes in mind for them. And unfortunately, due to the way that Commander's Choice now works, I can't use that. So, because, well, Commander's Choice only allows you to change classes while they're still a squaddy. But if a rookie gets promoted from a mission, they go straight to Lance Corporal, which is above squaddy. So my tip to you is, if you have specific classes in mind for your characters, quick save before you
Commander,
promote them.
To the research labs.
Yes, I'll get to that. Quick save before you promote them, and then quick load if you don't get what you're looking for with their classes. Also, something I forgot to turn off was not created equally. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna keep that on. Forget that. Anyways, first things first, though, we gotta get through the usual intro cutscenes.
Impressive, isn't it? Capable of generating immense power, yet completely harmless to human life. If only the same could be said for the rest of the aliens' technology, Commander. Dr. Richard Tigan, Chief Science Officer. I am responsible for the entirety of our research here, as well as the procedure you so recently underwent. Welcome to my lab, such as it is. I'm not sure what Central may have told you, but we found something while removing you from the alien stasis suit. A device implanted directly in your occipital lobe. Had I access to the equipment available to me during my tenure at Advent, I would already know the precise nature of its function. However, given time and your approval, of course, Commander, I assure you, I will find out. Which brings to light an additional point. Though aspects of this facility are indeed impressive, I am but one man. Were you to direct additional support personnel and resources to me, I could substantially improve the speed of all our research. A farewell, Commander.
Yep, research is pretty much the same, but there are new additions to it. Currently what we need right now, though, is resistance communication. Though, might not be a bad idea to research this other stuff. Oh, also, in addition, there's also some new basic research, which basically, when you complete it, and you can do it multiple times, it'll make future research more efficient. So it's basically like, I could spend 22 days on this, but it'll reduce something, I'm guessing either time or cost, in a future research research projects. And engineering research is the same thing, but it reduces costs for building things from engineering. Very useful. And like basic research, it can be done repeatedly. Right now, let's focus on resistance communication.
I do find that area of research to be among the more intriguing options available. We'll begin work immediately. I'll send word when a complete report is available.
Okay. Reworked your repulsors with some of the parts I salvaged from their old engine. Should fix that stabilization problem you had. Come on, Rover. It'll work. Commander! Getting our tech to talk to theirs is harder than you'd think. Lily Shen, Chief Engineer. At your service. You were probably expecting to see my father. In all that's happened, I'm guessing Central didn't tell you yet. He's gone. Dad gave everything he had to get us this far. This entire ship is his life's work. I know he would have loved to show you around the place himself. He used to talk about you a lot. You can be sure I'm ready to finish what he started. Might not look it, but from here, I can fabricate pretty much anything you come up with. And with a little more help, well, you'd be amazed with what I can do. It was an honor to finally meet you, Commander.
Right. Well, unlike in the base game...
You'd be surprised how big of a difference some of these things can make in combat, Commander. With a few supplies, I can manufacture anything we need in no time.
Anyways, like I was saying, unlike in the base game, the only thing we can currently build is a shaped charge. Ordinarily, we'd also be able to build a med kit, flashbangs, smoke bombs, or smoke grenades. But in Long War II, those things are already provided in unlimited amounts, so that's something that I actually like that they did.
As far as I can tell, Advent's technology, along with most of what we've seen going on in the city centers, is based on variations, and in some cases, improvements, of the existing alien tech used during the invasion. Luckily, the more common this stuff becomes, the easier it'll be for us to find components that can work in conjunction with the Avengers' hybrid systems.
Alright, off to the commander's quarters.
Hello, Commander. The council you once knew is no more. Its membership have all sworn loyalty to the Advent administration. With one exception. It is good to see you again. In the days since your capture, I have done all I can to aid the resistance from the inside. It was these resistance operatives that provided the intel leading to your recent extraction. As of now, resistance forces are currently somewhat disorganized. If we are to defeat Advent and their alien masters, you must change this before it is too late.
Right. As you can see, we have a new option, resistance management, but I'll get to that once I've promoted my soldiers, which will probably take a while, knowing my luck. I'll see you guys when we've finished with that. Well, this is odd. I guess this must have been in that update that happened after I started playing my personal playthrough. But apparently they're letting me choose the class that I want for them. Could just be that not created equally type deal, but I don't know. Let's go with a sharpshooter for Ruby. Huh. That is odd. Or it could be that she just didn't get as many kills as the rest of her squad. Oh well, we'll find out in a minute. No, that's not it. Weird. Oh well, Coco, you're gonna be a gunner. Still, better to err on the side of caution. That Nora is going to be a Grenadier, and Crow will be our Assault. Oh, and there's actually an option you can make, or activate. Not sure if that's part of Long War. Let's see, abilities, view locked perks, which will allow you to look at all of the perks that are typically locked until you get that promotion, which I find can be useful for when you want to plan out what skills you want to get for your different soldiers. Okay, well, with that taken care of, let's head to the bridge.
Commander, good to see you on your feet again. Welcome to the bridge. The nerve center of our operation. The aliens have our entire world in their grip. Advent controls everything. Government, communications, industry. Not to mention the military. And it's on us to take it all back. Resources and time are tight, Commander. It'll be up to you to decide how to best use both. The ship is yours.
Yes, well, things are different.
While we prepare for new operations and continue our research, we can pass time by scanning at sites like this one. On your order, we'll start our scans on the surrounding area.
As you notice, there is now all of these symbols, which are essentially how this game now works. You see, no longer it's just a simple matter of going out and scanning at an area, get a bunch of stuff while everything goes on. There are still those scanning places that you can look up, but they are far and few between. Also, supplies are no longer a set thing. It's no longer, yeah, you get this many supplies from this place and this many from this place. That is determined by Haven management. Now, as you can see, we have, six to start off with. It's not much, but it's all we're gonna get. And we can have them performing different jobs. We can have them gathering supplies, which is how we determine what our income is. We can have them recruiting new people to our havens, because this will get us two things. One, it can get us new soldiers to recruit, and two, it can get us new resistance members for the haven. Now, that does come with a risk, but I will explain that risk when it becomes a problem. We can also have them gathering intel, which is how we get our missions. If you have nobody gathering intel, then you're not going to be getting missions. However, any negative effect from missions carried out, whether we know about them or not, will still happen. We can also have them hiding. Let's say, because, well, you see this number down here, Advent Strength? That's how hard Advent is fighting back against resistance in this area. The higher it is, the tougher the enemies we're going to fight. So if it's getting too high, you might want to put all your people into hiding just to, you know, keep Advent from attacking them while they're doing their jobs. Now, because of two mods I have installed, I also have the Manufacture and the Liberate job. Manufacture basically means that resistance members will, well, manufacture things for you. utility items, weapons, armor, which is all dependent on what you have researched, and also dependent by how many supplies they're pulling in. Now, I'm not really going to be bothering with this at first, because, well, we don't have a lot going on. Or we're not going to have a lot of supplies coming in. There is also the Liberate job, which is kind of like the Intel job, except it focuses specifically on liberation missions, which we're going to need. Because by the end of the game, you have to have liberated at least one region in order to progress the story. You don't have to liberate all of them, but you have to get at least one. Again, I'm not going to be focusing on that at first. So, my typical recommendation for when you first get to an area is put the majority of people on recruiting, because you want to get as many resistance members in here as possible. And then have the rest on intel, because here's the thing, even if you got them all on supply, they're not going to be pulling in a lot. One other thing that's different are Haven Advisors. Basically, you can send in a soldier, an engineer, or a scientist, and each one does different things. Engineers will boost supply jobs. Basically, they'll make it so that they pull in more supplies, at least the people that are working on supplies. Scientists will boost intel jobs. Basically, you'll be getting more missions. Soldiers actually serve two purposes. Now, here's the thing. They have to be higher than a rookie in order to do this. And I believe also higher than a squaddie in order to be used as a Haven Advisor. But they serve two purposes. One, they boost recruitment, which means you're more likely to get more recruits. And they also serve another purpose, but I'll explain that at a later time. Now, as it starts out, we have no engineers, no scientists, and we don't really have enough high-ranked soldiers to spare for these missions. So, yeah. We're not going to be sending them out, so there's not going to be any Haven Advisors here. As it stands, I'm going to keep 4 people on recruitment and 2 on intel, just so that we get missions. Now that that's done, the black market, which you typically only get until your, I believe, 2nd month, now shows up immediately. Very useful. So we'll start scanning here to unlock the black market for us to buy things at.
Remote scanning capabilities will help us search the area for clues or other resources. It's going to take some time, though. We've got a lot of ground to cover.
Let's see. Alien alloys and Illyrium crystals are what they're interested in this month. Well, I don't think I have either of those. Or if I do, they're in very short supply. Yeah, no. Not selling anything. Let's see what we can buy. Scientist, engineer, a shinobi. Could be useful, but eh. A hair trigger. Now, here's the thing about certain mods. They have been changed, and they've also added some new ones. The hair trigger, which, if I recall correctly, gave you a chance to not use up an action point when you shoot an enemy, or when you shoot your gun, period. This time, they've changed it up so that you get bonus aim on reaction fire, basically Overwatch shots. Which, if you have somebody who, if you have somebody who has something like Ever Vigilant or an ability that lets them take multiple Overwatch shots, is very useful. They also added in the stock, which, when equipped, grants your soldier the ability to use steady weapon to increase their aim and critical chance on their next shot. Very useful on sharpshooters. They've also added PCSs, or some new PCSs, but, well, I can't use those yet until I gain access to until I build the GTS, which is probably going to be a while before I do that. Nothing I really want to buy right now. So, that'll be that. Now, in order to forward time, if there's no scanning site for you to go to, because like I said, they are far and few between, you can just go to any nearby haven and just click this right here.
Although we have allies scattered in cities throughout the globe who are willing to share their knowledge of Advent's operations, the aliens are actively pursuing them. It will be up to you to ensure the safety of our operatives, Commander. Good luck.
Yes. Extract a VIP from an Advent city. Now, when it comes to these missions, don't just pay attention to the reward and the main objective. You also gotta want to pay attention to here, because that will tell you different things that it does. Basically, in this case, it's find a lead, which is going to help us in liberating this region. But they also do other things. For example, there's one mission that will allow you to reduce Advent's strength in the region, or in some cases, if you have multiple regions, draw Advent's attention away from a specific region to that region. It can be useful. And keep in mind, this extremely light, that can still be very difficult, especially early on when you only have rookies. And let's see, in this case we get an engineer, which we sorely need, and an intel package. Now, missions work differently in Long War II. No longer is it just go in and you're immediately in the mission. Instead, what happens, and you know what, I'm actually going to change my mind on the not created equally.
Commander, we currently have no new supplies coming in. We'll need to seek out new means of replenishing our resources.
Yes, I know that, Bradford. Now, where was I? Oh, right, the mission. Basically, what you do is you select a squad, and they go in to infiltrate the area. Now, because of the fact that I also want to get other people promoted, I'm probably going to select some other people to go with one of the squaddies. Because you want to get people promoted as soon as possible. Because getting people who have, well, who basically have these abilities is going to make the early game somewhat easier. But anyways, guys, I'm going to cut the recording here and come back to you once I've made my decision. Okay, I'm back and I've made my selection. We're going with Ruby, Weiss, Blake, Yang, and Sapphire. Now, something I forgot to mention earlier. You're going to want to pay attention to this part of the screen. This is very important. Oh, also I created a bunch of squads. You want to pay attention to mission expiration time, which in this case is 6 days and 14 hours. You also want to pay attention to how long it will take to infiltrate. That's right, you're no longer just sending someone out and doing the mission. You actually have to take time to infiltrate the mission. Now, at baseline, we have 4 days to infiltrate. However, because we have a less than maximum sized squad, we actually get to subtract 19 hours off of our infiltration time. And we can either get increased or decreased infiltration time based upon certain abilities and gear that they're carrying. For example, a gunner carrying a, well, heavy gun is going to make infiltration a little bit harder. But anyways, without further ado, almost forgot again, every soldier starts out with one frag grenade, one flashbang, and this, a new item added in, ceramic plating. Basically what it does is it gives you two ablative armor points, which in this case is the equivalent of a shield. Once it's gone, it's gone, but any damage against that doesn't get through, will not count against a flawless. Also, I didn't discover this until after I got nano medkits, but medkits are given to you unlimited in full supply. I actually thought that you needed to unlock regular medkits through research, but no. Also, something to keep in mind, each piece of gear will reduce your mobility by 1. There are certain pieces of gear that don't do this, but with what I'm going for, they will. So, without further ado, let's start our infiltration. Now, it'll seem like it's standard, them just flying out there. But...
Skyranger deployed. Squad green to deploy.
As you'll see, it'll fly there, but then it'll fly back. What needs to happen is time needs to pass. Now, if we were to go in now, which would be the most horrible idea in the world, we would encounter heavy enemy activity. But the higher our infiltrated status, the lower the current enemy activity is, and the lower the enemy readiness is. Now, I'm not 100% sure what enemy readiness does. It might have an effect on their sight radii, or how likely reinforcements are to show up. I'm not entirely sure. But there are 3 things you can do. You can view the squad that's currently on mission. You can boost their infiltration, which I'll get into a little bit later. And you can abort the mission. Now, there's no shame in aborting a mission. If you find that you just cannot get the level of infiltration that you need, abort it. It's better to abort and fail a mission than it is to lose an entire squad because you weren't ready for what was there. And believe me, even at extremely light, enemies can still be very tough. But we're gonna let that keep going, because we've got nothing else to do.
Predicted this outcome, though it is intriguing.
And we've finished resistance communications. We can now build resistance comms, which I won't be doing. And we've also unlocked Resistance Radio, which allows us to build radio relays, which, believe me, are very important, because they've actually doubled the cost of contacting a new region. And that is if you're contacting a region that's directly next to a region you have a radio relay built in. So it'll cost you 60 for each region you have to go through that doesn't have a relay. But because that takes 17 days, I'm going to hold off on that and instead focus on modular weapons.
I'll see that work begins immediately, Commander. I'll contact you when I have a full report available.
And before I forget it...
There's room for us to expand our facilities on board the Avenger, Commander, but we'll need more engineers to clear out space for construction first.
Yes, well, thankfully we don't need an engineer to do construction just for clearing out rooms. I mean, yeah, it speeds it up, but still. First thing that I highly, highly recommend building is the Advanced Warfare Center, because with all the new enemies, chances are very high your soldiers are going to get wounded, and they're going to need this in order to recover quicker.
Advanced Warfare. We'll start work on the new facility right away, Commander.
And
I'll
even
send word when it's up and running.
And even without an engineer, it's only going to take 12 days. But with that, our time is actually up for this episode. I know we didn't get to a lot of action, but we will definitely be having a mission in the next episode.
The Advent propaganda machine is running full steam. We're picking up their transmissions even way out in the middle of nowhere.
So don't worry, there will be action in the next episode. It's just that there's a lot of new stuff that Long War introduces that I feel like I should explain. So, if you guys like what you see, please leave a like and subscribe for future content. See you guys in the next episode.